stare into the face of murderous despair. Hello everybody, and welcome to a Let's Look At of Unbox by Prospect Games. Do not trust anybody that smiles like this. And this is it's an interesting game. It's a 90s style 3D platformer, at least that's how the developers describe it, and you play as a sentient box, created by GPS, and if we come around here, self-delivering boxes, that's what we play as. I only recently managed to finally find the place where I was supposed to customize my box. But yeah, we are playing as a box, and it harkened, well, once you see the area we're going to muck around for this, Paradise Isles, it has a very reminiscent feel to, like, say, Mario 64 to me. You know, that just kind of feel, you're let loose in an area, and in Mario 64 the goal was, hey, find stars. Do whatever you need to, but find the stars. In this one it's doing, well, finding stamps, finding golden duct tape, freeing trapped boxes, and there is a little bit of a storyline as well. I also never came in here before, actually. What's in here? Who are you? Command terminal for door 15AC. That's the big red door in the cold storage chamber. Can I open it? Can I? Oh, yeah, I can. So that's probably a secret. This is our starting hub. This is the company base, I guess. It's called Other Base, a kind of parody of Mother Base from Metal Gear Solid. Oh, it only opens for a few seconds, eh? Alright. Not going through there. Because we are going to go to the Paradise Isles and kind of muck around. But yeah, there's tons and tons of collectibles to get. There's another switch here. Hang on. I'll go over the controls once we're actually in Paradise Isles, so... ignore this for a little bit. I want this. There we are. Alright. These are explosives, by the way. I really wish I hadn't dropped into the water when I did that. Luckily my checkpoint is right here. Oh! I did not know there was a tape hidden under there. So what is this? Oh! Mystery Uncoverer. I just got an achievement. This might be accidental spoilers, apologies. Mayday, mayday, my ship is being sucked into a black hole. I took a shortcut, but it's not safe at all in the black hole sector. If anybody is reading this, please help me! Alright. That's a layer of this I was not expecting to discover. Because I wasn't really planning on mucking around in here. Might as well get the tape plant. Oh. Well, I'm here. One thing to get used to, you are not a sphere. You do not roll and bounce properly. It reminds me of trying to use the square ball in golf with your friends. That's what it's like. But anyway, I'll get this tape. I'll get this tape. No, I won't. Oh, yeah, well, there we are. Alright, let's get to Paradise Isles, and I'll talk a little bit about what is actually going on here, although I just noticed I missed one. Oh, there's one under there as well. There. Although if I touch the checkpoint, I get my bounces back. Which we'll talk about more once we actually get to Paradise Isles by going in the shipping container. Yes, let's go there, please. Okay. I'll be honest, I've spent like just over an hour with the game so far, and I've mostly just been pissing around. I've not been really focusing. I've just been exploring and doing stuff as I find it, which I think is fine. It feels like you're able to do that. Well, let's skip this cutscene. There's no voice acting. Yeah, we're just here to do the stuff in the bottom right there. So, I'm using the 360 controller. You can use mouse and keyboard if you want. Using the left analog stick to move, right one to look around, and you can either use left bumper, right bumper, or left trigger, right trigger to jump, and then also unbox. And the number of times you can unbox are in the bottom left, and you can restore those with these healths. So for example, jump, unbox, put me down to 5, and then that's back to 6. The reason you have those unboxes is to let you gain height like this. But again, you have a limited amount, so you have to be careful. And you use that to get to secrets and what have you. So, I think, I can't remember what engine this was built in, but there's something about the visual style that was very familiar to me. I'm not sure what I played recently that it reminded me so much of. The gameplay feels like Mario 64 in that you're free to kind of do whatever you like. Don't forget to free any traps. Oh, that probably means there is someone trapped around here somewhere. Down here? No, there's just more collectibles. In terms of like set, oh, there he is. Instead of, what am I trying to say here? In terms of set stuff to do, there's races that you can do. I've found those so far. I've only done one, but there's two more I can do, and that will earn you a stamp if you do them all. If you touch the water, by the way, you bounce once and then you drown. Assuming you don't touch land again after that. Oh, he's got a gun. I don't know what's waiting for us at the end of this. We're being shot at, though. Mailbox! Oh, hey, a hidden stamp! 13 out of 18, I wish. 3 out of 18! Also, oh, I want to get back in style. Can I use this? You can ride vehicles, I've done it before. Maybe not this one, though. It doesn't have an arrow on it, so I assume that means I can't steer it. Nah, that's a shame. Alright, well, let's try and get back in style, then. Boing. Get momentum, and use that momentum for great success. It's a good job I touched dry land. So the game plays smoothly. I've had no real issues with it. The music for this particular area is a little grating after a while because it's kind of like that same Hawaiian loop over and over. Small complaint, but you know. I would also say if you're not the kind of person who enjoys kind of like just exploring and doing random stuff and collecting crap like this, you know, the crackdown mentality, you might find the lack of specific direction where to get the stamps annoying. Maybe. I'm not sure. What is this? There's very clearly a stamp hidden in this house. Sometimes I find blue shiny things on my morning roll. Then I bring them back here. Can I get in? I require this. Oh, wait. I think I'm going to blow up his house. Yeah I am. 6 more unlocks a thing, it seems. Oh! Was a blue shiny thing important? That's okay, you can have this. Oh, thank you. It's not often I blow up someone's house and they thank me for it. I mean, I've never blown up anyone's house. Except that guy's. See, you can just... You cause reckless destruction for no real reason, but other than it's kind of fun. And I like that. It's been a little while since I've played a game like this where you can just kind of muck around and the game is fine with it. Now, again, if you feel like you need direction, you need pointed to where... Oh, hello stamp. Oh wait, no. You're going to give me some kind of minigame to earn a stamp. Let's hear what it is. Just in time, newbie. I bought the speedboat, but wild cards came and stole half the parts from it. It still floats, which is nice, but I want to drive my speedboat. Vroom, aha! Anyway, newbie, can you help me get those parts? Certainly. Thank you, newbie. The parts are scattered around the shanty village. Who knows why the wild cards want them? The wild cards are just... baddies. You can bounce on them or you can ignore them. I assume this will be timed, then. Is it? Oh, it is timed. It's essentially a different type of race. Oh, they have guns. I laugh in the general direction of your puny weapons. Please don't hurt me. I think I may have missed some back there, unfortunately. Let's get some height. Whoa! That noise is them doing an attack! I have never seen this attack before, this is ridiculous! I'm alive. Somehow. Oops, I accidentally went into an explosive. I was trying to get health. That's actually the first time I've been defeated, though it doesn't really matter. This town is going to be wrecked by the end of this. Get out of my way. I really do need this, though. See what I mean about trying to steer into things? Don't mind me. Out of 20. 16. Ah, they're up there. Can really use that HP. Because not only do the unboxings give you height and distance and speed, etc., they are also your HP. There's the last one right there. With time to spare, we are done. The stamp is mine. Whee! You found the speedboat parts. Not all of them, though. Oh, come on. It looks like some wild cards ran off with their own speedboats. If you get these last few parts, I've got a stamp I'll trade. You're changing the deal on me, QD. 4 left on the speedboats. This is going to be harder. For sure. Here we go. Ow! Drop me there. Oh, they actually helped me, thank you! Alright, they're helping me out again, actually. I have no, like, movement, though. Damn it. I just wanted the HP, that's all. Oh, that was worst possible timing for that one. I'm not going to have the height required, I think, to catch up. Nope, this is going to be it. Ooh, barely. Where's the last one? Is that it? Oh, that boat over there? At least this one doesn't have a timer. I think that box might be staring at me. Oh, the health's respawned though. See you later! Oh no! There we go! This is nothing too serious, it's one of those just silly games. You'll be seeing this after the release date, by the way, because of my backlog. It's released on September 5th, but I am playing this before release. And at present, there is no price listed, so I can't tell you if the price they're asking for is fair for what is here. And do keep in mind these are first impressions and generally just kind of showing off the general gameplay more so than any kind of in-depth reviewing. Assuming their average indie game price, which means, say, between £6 and £12, you're probably going to get your money's worth if you like kind of retro-y 3D platformers. Any more than that and I would start to question it. But it depends how many different areas there are, I'm not sure. I've only ever experienced the other base parody thing and also this area. Hopefully there is more and it's got flavours, you know, like an ice area, that kind of thing. That would be greatly appreciated. Whether or not it does, though, I don't know. You'd have to check out the reviews on Steam, which will be linked in the description box. And by the time you see this, there will be a price listed there as well. So let's try and go to a different island. Actually, I've never climbed that, and I want to. So let's go see if we can do that. The fastest way back is probably just jumping the water, I think. Geronimo! Easy. We'll take those. So, how do I get atop this garbage tower? CJ Construction Group Incorporated. Oh, I've definitely not been here before. Oh, getting that checkpoint would be a good idea. There's a mini game here I can. Oh, hang on, this is the wild card's base. What do you want? What do you want? Well, that's too bad because you need 10 stamps before Boss Wild will even look at you. So get lost. Alright, so you come back to him and the story will start another phase if you get 10 stamps. That said, though, can I just climb up here? I'd very much like to. Keep your eyes open for trapped zippies. So that must mean there's another cage here somewhere. What else do we have here? Another checkpoint. Why not? There are tons of unlockables that you can customize yourself with, by the way. You can get yourself like a monocle, a top hat, you know, the usual kind of stuff. To make your box look weird, any colour you want as well. Thud. Have you ever had to do manual labour before? Yes, I have. Then you understand. It's so hectic and such hard work, and you get treated like crap by the public. And nobody even knows why we're building this darn radio tower. No, maybe it's not aliens, no matter what those dumb zippies say. Now pay attention and stop thinking about aliens for a moment. I may have accidentally left my hard hat at the top of the radio tower yesterday. Oh good, you're gonna make me go up there anyway. I was about to, so this kills two birds with one stone. You'll go get it? Thanks. Alright, place bets. People watching. How many times am I gonna fall off this tower? Climb to the top of the radio tower and retrieve Thud's hard hat. Challenge accepted! Please don't be like a 30-second... timer. No timer at all, perfect. Alright. Because steering when you're a box and you're not round makes things difficult. You know what a hard hat looks like, don't you? Gee, I don't know, also I didn't realise that was not a a jump, but that's fine. Try not to run into any of the explosives, that could get bad. I do want this though. I mentioned I don't like heights. Not a fan. Oh, that's a crusher. We're higher than that plane. That does not seem healthy. Also, what is that? Oh, it's a strut. Well, it's this game's version of a strut. Crushers are the GPS's idea of stopping pigeons. Cruel and unusual punishments. Ooh, very nearly overshot. Very nearly undershot. I just went in here for this. There we are. Was that worth like the 3 unboxings I used to get there? Probably not. Shut up, thud. Stare into my face, it's the face you'll see before you die. We're almost there, I think. There's been no health for a little while though. The conveyor was another anti-pigeon idea GPS had. Oh. We're fine. Oh, there's a checkpoint. That means we're not done yet. I'm just going to throw myself off the top of this. That is the smile people will see as I splat into the ground. You're late. Those should not be falling off, I think. We keep TNT on the tower just in case we need to start again. That's good to know. I thought you were just being silly. Careful now. Careful. Careful. Ah! Very nearly. Give me it because I had to use that. There's a stamp just sitting there. I can't ignore it. Oh, I got back, but I used up the last of my unboxings. I hate heights. Even in-game heights. Careful now. Don't touch the explosives or you die. Not where we're to go. Up here and across. I overjumped. No, then I underjumped. These damn boxes bounced me. Oh, there is no god. Nope, we're doomed. Shit. We're okay. I can recover from this. There's no reason to tilt. Unless that's a thing boxes do. Respawn. Actually, what I could do, this because these healths respawn, right? Maybe? They do! I would like to wait until I get a couple more. Just so we make sure we see the top of this tower before... Cannot speak today. The top of this tower before I stop the video. But as we're waiting, I'll just remind you that this is Unbox by Prospect Games. Available by the time you hear this. Might get up like in the opening week though, so if there's any kind of special price on buying the game on opening week, it should still be there. Yep. Right, is this where I messed up last time? Kinda. And then we came up here, and then we got the stamp from back there. With all the TVs, is this a reference? I wanted to knock them over, but I can't. Up we go. If nothing else, we're getting a very nice view of this area. A checkpoint. See the hard hat, I think. Oop. Damn it. Judging these 3D jumps. There we are. Just leap off the tower and bring me that hat. I'm gonna enjoy the view first. Can I sit in this? I totally can! The face of despair. So there's the island with a... Oh, I didn't see that before. That's actually where the plane lands. There's an airport. Over there's the shantytown, I think. There's the other plane we saw. There's where I came in at the port in the distance there on the top of the screen. Yeah, it's a pretty big playground. I assume this isn't the only playground you get. If it is, I mean, it is quite big, but even then... Oh, there's the islands I jumped out to as well. It's nice that it's all rendered. You can definitely see that stuff is still moving. So which direction is that airport? The airport is over there. Alright. Whee! My hard hat! Just in time too, the GPS inspection force will be here any minute. Quick, take this stamp and get out of here! I'll take my tramp stamp, thank you very much. 7 out of 18, so I need 3 more and then I can do the next story mission, by the looks of it. Box thud. Visit Swift Tailoring to try it on, so now I can become that guy. So the airport was over there. There it is, right there. Place bets now. Do I have enough height for this? I think I do. Easy. There's a lot of explosives on this beach. Is there a checkpoint? Before I start jumping after collectibles, I would very much like a checkpoint. Or just some more HP, actually. Checkpoints! Alright, we'll take a quick look at the airport. For no other reason than to satisfy my own curiosity, really. Then that will do it for this little look at unboxing. You can learn more at the Steam Store page, which will be linked below. If it's your thing, and I hope they are asking for a reasonable price, because for standard indie price, this is a nice little fun thing to muck around in, especially if you're my age and you grew up with early 3D platformers in the 90s. Can we get inboard? Inboard? Onboard? That's spitting out stuff. Any other secrets, I wonder? There's a bit of a problem here, though. So this. The stamp is on fire! Or in fire. You should find the emergency gas switches and turn the fire off. Maybe I'll do that, maybe I won't. I haven't decided yet. There's another stamp tearing up here by doing something. Who are you? It's a box, it's a shark. You have a new box, it's the talk of the island. Yes, I am! Ben's told me you'd be rolling around to meet everybody. My name is Splash, but you can call me Splash. Me and Zippies, my best friends, were playing on the beach when we found a mysterious glowing thing. All of a sudden, wild cards appeared from him and, yep, stole the glowing thing. I managed to get away, but the poor Zippies are now trapped on the beach. If you help me save the Zippies, you can have the stamp I found. Except, well, that's quite far away, isn't it? They've also got a helicopter. Alright, I guess we'll take a quick look at this minigame since I started it. I couldn't resist. Box-O-Matic in the top right there. What I need to do to save them? Just touch them? Yes. Oh wait, no, I have to take them back! Ah, that's interesting. Whee! He just sits back down. Oh, this is interesting. I like the variety. At first I was worried they were all just going to be races. But no, there is more to it than that. Get! Yeah, I don't want to use an unboxing just to get up here. There we are. Then shortcut back. Two out of four. Really should stop using unboxes for that though. Ah! I didn't realize I touched the water once already. Whoa! That's a little high. It's the helicopter that's shooting at me, isn't it? Well, thank you for sending me where I needed to go! Challenge complete! Although the last box I saved actually just drowned in the water, I think. Whoa, you saved everybody except that one box who drowned. I owe you more than just a stamp! Maybe I can change into this guy now, or I'll get the rubber ring schematic or something. Huh? No, he said I deserved more, but didn't actually give me anything more. Oh, there's a guy to free as well. Anyway, I'm getting distracted just doing stuff. This has been Unboxing. I hope you enjoyed. Thank you for watching, and I shall see you next time. Ta-ta for now.